Welcome back from That Should Break. You're still watching Abin today right here on Abin Television. Remember, we are live on social media. All you need to do is make sure you have some data and some OTT. Head over to our social media pages. For Facebook, it is Abin Television, and Twitter, it is at Abin TV Uganda. Back in flesh. And now our love letter this morning has a very sad headline. My boss repped me. But here is the detail. Now, apparently, hello, please share this with your viewers. I feel so bothered. I came to Kampala in February 2014 in search for a job. And lucky enough, I got one along Salama Road as a shopkeeper. For the last 3 years, all was well as my female boss loved me so much and she paid me in time and gave me time to rest. However, on June 13th, 2017 at around 11 p.m., after I had closed the shop, I received a call from my male boss saying that he wanted to pick some money from the shop. Since I reside there, I opened the door, and when he entered, he raped me. I ran away, but my female boss looked for me and she's requesting me to come back to work, but I fear telling her the truth. Some of my friends told me not to tell her because it might break their marriage, yet they hold a high position in church. What should I do? Hide my identity, please. Yes, we'll definitely do that. And at this point in time, I would like to ask everyone, the viewers, to weigh in regarding this particular one and what should be the best advice for this lady. Later on, we shall have our studio lines open. The number to call will be communicated shortly. But for now, exchange of ideas right about now. Let's begin with Pac Mother.
Derek, at some point, abantu ngabano. Beta aga kukwatiwa. Ne baba sadako obuntu. Okay, now
rapist.
This letter, jisomye mune njidam, but the voice is of a little girl.
She
might
little?
Be not in age, but the intellect, njiple singa wonga 17, 18.
Really?
Yes, njiple singa wonga. Then also, murimu gwakodo, gweduka. Rarely do people employ people who are older than that because abayeta gomuntu, omwangu okutuma. Kakati. No church position is bigger than you. No marriage is bigger than you. You have been abused and you haven't taken a step. Because what are the chances that he has been doing it to the others who have been living? And you're the one who is brave enough to come back and even work. I think she needs to speak up and not speak up to the mommy, because when you go to that wife, you've already mentioned church position. You have already mentioned a marriage that seems to be solid based on rep. Go to the police or go to the church itself. There is always someone who wants to hate on them. Speak up. Do not keep quiet. Rep is rep. You have been sexually abused.
Okay. Tina Fierce, how about you? What do you make of this whole situation? I hope this is not one of those situations whereby you tell people to run away. Because she has already fled.
And been looked for.
That's just, she's being looked for.
First of all, it's sad. It is really sad for someone to take advantage of you. That is, for someone to take you at your own, without your own consent, is already, it rips a part of your soul away from you. And that's a part you don't get back. The only way you can rebuild that part back is by saying
speaking
it out. Out. Bine bintu byokwekwasa church.
Church. Obufumbo.
If you feel the boss is too good to you, the female one, be extremely good to her too in return by telling her the truth. Because she is harboring a rapist. If he can rape you, he could rape anything.
He will
rape your his mother, he will rape a child, have a serial rapist. Now, if you say this woman likes you so much, how about you reciprocate? How? Go to the police, put down your statement. Yes, time probably has already passed. They can't even do anything. They
ask for her to come.
Yes, they can't even do a whole rap kit situation on you medically. Mm. But the audacity he had to do that to you, rival it by having extra more audacity by putting it out. Shame them, name them. That is the only way time immemorial society has learned. Shame them, name them. Shame them, name them. It works all the time, because even if he's a pastor in a church and you shame him and name him, and igaza zijja kulabuka abadde bagenda yo musawa bwakulinda bwakukubira esimu nga sawa tozitegera omugamba oh word, no, I'm not around. Muyige. The most people wonder why I call a spade, why I have blunt honesty. I have blunt honesty because my honesty is the only thing that can set me free, and my truth is my honesty. Ochitegera. So I don't have to cover up anything.
And it's okay for your truth to be your truth.
Your truth is my truth.
My truth doesn't have to be your truth.
Thank you.
I want us to talk about, you know, what is the worst that could happen in case, you know, she went out ahead to, you know, shame them and name them?
Nothing.
That is going to be a conversation for immediately after this break. What you're going to do is write down this number, 0414-337-872. It is a studio line that you'll be able to get us on and be able to call us and let us know what should be the best advice for this lady. Should she go ahead to shame and name, or she should just move on and focus on her life after something very unfortunate did happen to her? Immediately after this break, we shall be opening the studio lines.